Today we're going to learn the halacha. If somebody by mistake put in a toaster oven or a regular oven, which is milchik, usually they either make a pizza over there or warm a pizza, and by mistake they put over there wrapped in a foil chicken inside. They didn't know, they thought it was a pizza wrapped in the foil. They put it inside this oven, they warmed it up, they can take it out, they see there's a chicken. What's the halacha? The shayla is on the chicken, and the shayla is, that was how the shayla came, and the shayla was also on the oven. If the chicken you could eat, if the oven you have to machshir, if it's become. Okay. So the good news is, the short answer is, you don't have to rebuild your kitchen, and you don't have to, you could eat the chicken that you warmed over there. It's kosher 100%, and the oven is also 100% kosher. So now, that's the short answer. Now we're going to say where it's coming from what's the origin of this. The Gemara in Pesachim Daf Ayin Vav, the Gemara says, Omar Rav, Bosor Shechuto Shomen Shatzloim Bosor Nevela Kochush Osur. My time of Fatma Mehadodel. I'm going to leave now the Nekud Avir, Bosar Shomen, Bosar Kochush, which is right now, it's not so much the ghettos. We're dealing now with the halacha, what's called, there's a discussion, if Reicha Milzu Alav, like this, the smell. The chicken was wrapped, so there's nothing went to the chicken, and nothing went back from the chicken to the oven, it's wrapped. The shayla is the smell. So this is the halacha of here between Rav and Levi, there's a machloik, is if Reicha Milzu or not. So if it was in the oven, in the case of Rav, there was kosher meat with a non-kosher meat, the same oven. So nothing got mixed up there, but the smell, if that's kosher or not. So Rav says it's osur, because the my time and mefatma me'adoda, they get some smell from each other. The smell translates to some taste too. The male, they get in, mixed up with each other's smell. It's osur. The Levi Omar afilo bosor shchuta kochush etzloyim bosor nevela shomen mutar. My timer reicha baalmu v'reicha lav milso. Levi Paskin, Levi said reicha is lav milso. So that's the machlokes. If the smell it's mamoshus, it makes osur something. Or the smell is no mamosh. Rav says it's osur. Levi says it's mutar. So Rashi brings like this. V'aval gav the kaimet tanoi kavosa de Rav. Even though there's many tanoim support the shita of Rav the Reich osur, hilchas a kavosa de Levi. And the reason he says the aloha like Levi though, if lugu abay v'rova gabe bas tia, the masechas avet zore. Masechas avet zore, this machlok is abay v'rova. If bas tia, it was people that had a profession, they made a hole in the barrel of wine and tell you by the smell if the wine is good or not, is going bad or not. Some people, they could say, with who, that's called Bastia, they made a hole in the... So the Gemara discuss over there, if a goy smells the Jewish wine, if it's okay, or vice versa, if a Jew allowed to smell the goyish wine, because it's Nehenna from the... From Yain Nesach, then you're not allowed to have Hanoah from it. So over there, that's also Machlok is Abai v'Rava. The Kamla Rava b'shitosa de Levi, and Rava over there goes according to Levi, v'Omar Reicha la'milsi. According to this, both ways, a goy could smell a Jewish wine, this doesn't make it any pagam in the wine, doesn't make it possible, doesn't make it Yain Nesach, or a Jew could smell a goyish wine, it's not Nehenna. Because Reicha lav milsahi, and since Rove, which is the latest, he was the later that he passed in like Levi that Reicha lav milsahi hilchas a krove. Bechenu b'tshuvas agohinim. Okay, v'af mishot Rabbi Elazar ben Yitzchak nemali de lochay shlo, meaning it's no shaila according to Rashi halacha like Levi Reicha lav milsahi. So meile according to this so far what we're learning. If somebody put the chicken wrapped in a foil, put fully wrapped inside the milchaka oven, so what could happen? The worst, some smell from the previous pizza was in that oven, went inside the chicken, or the chicken left a smell in the milchik oven, it's reichel lam milse, it's perfectly okay. So that's the, according to Rashi and many goinim, the Rabbeinu Tamo with their paskin like Rav, reichel milse, and it's osur. Without going nuts, I just gave you a little bit of background. Now, la halacha, what would do la halacha? Reichel milse, reichel lam milse, so it's like this. The tour brings up the Kosav Arashmo. Pascha, yeah? Okay, again, it's wrapped. It's wrapped. No, nothing goes through. You have a good point, but that's in this case, no. It was fully wrapped. No, nothing clicked. You're right. Nothing glue. When you talk about, there's no real thing involving. No shuma, no meat, just reach. Just reach. What? No. You're going to see soon how it's not only mutter, it's 100%, 120% it's mutter. I'm going to show you, I'm going to the origin to show you. I know people would say, oh, if they rebuild your kitchen. Okay, we'll talk about when it's we'll talk about all this, we're going to cover it. Okay, so Kosav Arashbo, that I'm reading from the tour now in your Yeredet Tzadik Zayin. Kosav Arashbo, pas shafoy betanur ima bosor, now it's another shaila. You in the same, now we're going to tell you what we're talking about over here. We're not talking in our case that you put the chicken wrapped in a foil. There was nothing there in the oven. The pizza was there maybe a day ago, maybe half a day ago. Nothing there. We're talking about the case in the tanurim. Today also you could, but at the same time you put in the oven over here, you could put bread over here is a meat. Let's say you did it. Don't touch each other. Especially if we're talking about, we're going to see there were the tanurim, they were open. The olden tanurim, adayom, you have them in many places where they make the pita, the lafa, an open tanur, which is, there's nothing mixing but the smell, yeah? So over there, if you put a bread with the meat, that bread become fleshik or not. Bread was cooked and baked the same time in the same oven with the meat, that the bread become fleshik or not. Kosav Arashbo, pas shafoy betandurim abosor, yesh ma'ag'oinim sh'osru l'echol oysa pas. Something says you cannot eat this bread with the milchik, yeah, because it's fleshik. Shereicha ketamoy. According to them, reicha milso, according to Rav, reich is like the tam, it's only smell, nothing else over there. V'yesh matirin, some say it's mutter, which is, that's the shita of Rashi and many goinim. V'chen nira, atkan, that's the shita of the Rashbo, that is from the matirin. V'chen posak Rashi, derech la milso, that's, I just read the Rashi, umutar l'ochle afilu b'cholom. According to him, not only you don't become fleshig by eating the bread, you could even take this bread, was in the same time in the oven with the meat, and you could put on it cream cheese, kneaded with the cream cheese. According to Rashi,
it's
part of it. Yeah. Now the tour comes over here. You bring the sheet of the Rabbeinu Tam. I just read you the sheet of Rabbeinu Tam. It is aloha karavi paskin. Reach milsehi. It is like tam. Okay, but it says even according to Rabbeinu Tam, miu davke betanur cotton. Only if it was a small tanur, it was intense smell. Aval betanurim shalonu. Hagdoilim, it's a big oven. We talk about it's a lot of air going out, and when the smell mixes, it's not so intense. She shore. That's you allowed to. So even according to Rabbeinu Tam, it's a loch reichem. By the way, I want to say another thing over here. When we say reichem milse, we're not talking about a regular smell. As we're going to see in halacha, we're talking about when you do on a fire, when you do a tzli on the fire. It's not a regular smell from, like I said, from an hour ago, from a day ago. It's you when you're roasting on an open fire barbecue, when you make a barbecue,
a fresh smell from now. Not only
fresh smell, but a fresh from an open fire. I'm gonna read it inside now. So I'm gonna tell
intense,
you about
an intense smell.
Very intense smell. Then it's a shaila, and then depends how small is the oven, how much is the opening, how much air flowing through.
Nowadays that wouldn't make a difference because ovens all have fans that move the air around, so that makes it worse. The fans moving the air.
Okay.
Inside the oven.
So I'm gonna. It's very good. So I don't want to talk about if you did it the same time. But the shaila is now if you did it afterwards.
Right.
If you do it the same time, okay, we can discuss this issue. Adarabah, I could have a tiny to say that the fan also extract some of this. So it could be like tanurim
gedolim. I think the fan just moves the air so it's equal everywhere in the oven.
Okay, that would be the convection of
most are now. Come back.
Okay, all right. So it depends how it's done. Okay, fine. Again, I'm talking about. I'm focusing now.
If it's no dough, if it's open, is it
difference.
You know, but most tanurim today, what they have in the house, it's closed. Okay, again, that wouldn't bake together. And you're going to see also over there, there is a shtikel heta. I'm going to tell you in a minute why. Okay. So here's the halacha in Shulchan Aruch. Pas shafoy matzli v'dogim shetzlon b'tanur echad im abosor osur l'ochlam b'cholov. Again, this is, would be like paskin, like Rav over here. V'ane mila b'tanur koton. That's only if it's a small tanur, that's what the Torah says. Abba b'tanur godol, that you're allowed to. Now, like this. The Shulchan Aruch still. V'cheni matzli mechuse. Let's say you're putting something in an open fire, but it's wrapped. Either is an open fire going in a tanur. The old tanur was an open fire, but the meat is covered inside the pot or covered in a foil. V'chen imatzlim mechusa, v'chen pashtida shemechusa hanekev shaboy. Pashtida, it was food that was wrapped with the dough. Sometimes they had an opening. The meat has an opening. You see, the meat sometimes it was completely covered. It's like we have today.
Pirashki.
How you say it in English?
I don't know. Meat pastries.
Meat pastries completely covered. Yeah, he said. V'chen b'shemchusa hanekev shor muter afilu b'tanur tzor. Even it's a small tanur, since the meat itself doesn't have any smell. Intense smell coming out. It's covered with the dough. That's allowed. Okay. So this is in Tzadik Zayin, but then the Shach tells you over here. So like this. The Shach talks about, it's important to quote over here. The Shach says what with the Shulchan Aruch Paskin in Siman Tzadik Zayin, that if it was in the same oven, it's Osur. Again, Pascha Foy Imatzli. He says, later on, which is the Shach gonna say, that's the main halachas of Reicha Milsa Olav, it's over there, and Siman Kufches and Taruvas. He says, even though over there, it's there, like this, im tolu bosor, kesheiro im bosor neveila, betanur echad, afilu koton, muter v'dievet. Over there, we're paskin v'dievet. If you have, comes out like this, if you had not only meat, with bread, you had mamash in the same oven, somebody put a treif of meat over there. Rachmana Letzan, who would think that to do in your house a treif of meat in your oven? The same time when you have your kosher meat, glad kosher meat, but the oven is mutter. Lechatchila we're not. So he says, "Bechera, why over here the Shulchan Aruch asked that?" Very, very simple. He says, "Hoha kevand evril ochla b'lo cholav havek lechatchila." When we matir, we have a tevim bottle. Or b'dievet, when you have no other choice. Over here, the bread, eat it with a fleishik. If you're not losing anything, over there, we're talking about, if I'll tell you the meat is treif, because it was next to a treif of meat, you have a loss. So it's coming, the teirim, b'dievet is mutter, recha lav milsehi, or it's not intense recha. So now we're going to go to kufches again. So again, bosor, b'tzad bosor, b'cholov, b'machmir, not because it's more chomer. They both had teirim. That's more easier. This is heter. This is heter together. Because over there you have a. If you put a bread together in an oven with the milchik or fleishik, eat it with the same thing later on. There's no loss over there. So we're not gonna tell you b'dievet. It's lachatchil later. Now it says over in kufches in taruv. It says like this. En soilen bosor kesherim bosor nevela. O shel behema tameya b'tanur echad. Don't do that. Don't put together at the same time in your oven kosher, non-kosher meat. But however, im tzalon areze muter. But the eved, if you did it, it's muter again. But the eved was soy mechand shita reicha la milsei. Okay, now like this. Then he says in tanur godel. That's already. I just want to show you how far it goes that people scared so much. We don't have that today. Maybe in some commercial ovens where they do the pitas, the lavash, and they have them some of these, some in Eretz Yisrael, they make in front of you the pita. He says, "V'im atanur gadol shemachzik yudbeis estrim v'piv pasuach mutar litzloisam boy ubilvach la'igu zebze." So the Shulchan Aruch tells you, You it's could open. Go lechatchila if you have an open oven. There's a lot of smoke over there, but it's all flying away from the opening. You could lechatchila put over there.
If he has a door, like there's an oven like the size of the Ohr Kodesh, a commercial oven.
If it's open while you do it, while you do it, if it's open, yeah. Well, some saying there's a difference between the door is on top of the I'm not going to go. I'm not going to do the details of it right now because what's nagia to us is nishke nafkemina anyway. But if you have a big opening and the smoke is not intense over there, so you lechatchila, he says you could put over there kosher meat and not kosher meat, the same oven. Could you imagine who would do that today? Al pi halacha, you could put it there. He said, as long as they don't touch each other. Ah, recha, recha la milsi. Especially when it's not so intense, the recha, it's open tanur. Then he goes further. Here, v'im echad mehem mechutze b'kairo b'botzek. That's what I mentioned before. Either it's inside the pot, it's covered pot. Or it's inside the bread. The meat is inside the bread. He says, v'chayoytzu b'mutan litzloysam afilu b'tanur koton u'piv sosum. Can you imagine, according to this, in our tanurim today, you could put over there a closed pot of kosher, a closed pot of treif, and it says according to Shulchan Aruch, you're allowed to do it. Okay, again, we're machmir, we're not going to do it. We might say maybe there's a zeya over there licking all the chumts, fine. Mikar adin, if you have a covered pot of milchik, a covered pot of fleishik, or treif with a kosher cover, with a foil, with a pot, or with a butzak even, inside the covering of the meat, or the cheese that's covered with the dough, you're allowed to do it lechatchila. Okay, now it's like this. Now says so far again, going back to the meat. The meat was covered. It wasn't even the same time with the pizza over there. It was few hours later. There's no intense smell. The whole idea of pasuach, tanur pasuach, because the smell goes away. There's no smell. It's a long time ago. Any smoke was there. Long time is gone. There's no, it's not even recha milsa. It's not recha even, according to this. That's no problem. Now, the Ramos are this. Yesh omrim, de'en matirin recha, afilu b'di'evet, elim ken atanur pasuach k'tzas minatzad o lamay lamokam shoshna. So the Ramos is clear. There's no nafkemin at like you said, if the doors are open, only then it would be okay. If there's b'di'evet, so according to the Ramo, you won't be allowed to put in the oven. The Shulchan Aruch says lechatchila, if it's covered, he says no, you cannot do this unless it's open, there's some opening, a big opening. Okay, I'm going to skip the some of the stuff. Yeah. According to the Ramo, if it's covered, it's going back to the head of the Shulchan Aruch. Even one of them is covered, they're both kosher because they don't mix. Then it's like this. Buadin im afu b'chaygan apasim abosar osur lochla b'cholav aval b'tze achar ze en lochush. The case of the putting a chicken wrapped in a foil inside the toaster oven or the milchike oven was bezeh harzeh. No problem, he said.
Only if you put them together would it be.
Oh, elaim ken yizia machvas mishneyem, those oster afilu bezeh harzeh, mo yishneyem megulim, dame ke kisu shel kedera. Yeah, well, lechatchila we don't do it, but maybe there's a zeya of milchik, of fleishik, but if it's covered, he says, it's no problem. So we see from here that it's not, and furthermore, the poskim said this whole thing. Oh, I'm going to bring this from the Lavush. The Lavush is, the Shulchan Aruch said the same thing, but the Lavush is, he explained this a lot clearer. The Lavush said, here's a punchline over here, why, b'chalal, it's not a problem. Again, but b'lechatchila, we don't do all of those things. We're very, you have big chumras and bosar b'chalav. A lot of it, it's chumras. Here's what the Lavush says. Look at that, it's in Shulchan Aruch, but he a little bit elaborates and explains this better. When we said reicha milsa or lav milsa, but tzli shereicha hoylech lemerochet, an open fire tzli, because the smell is very intense. It's, you see a smoke when you do a barbecue. It's not like when you're cooking. It's, you see a lot of smoke. Reicha over here, it's not just a little smell. Reicha hoylech lemerochet, whether it's open or not, there's a lot of smoke over there. He says reicha, it's a mamish intense reich of the fire, not stam reich of a little from the food. I'm going to show you how I get them. Avol im bol vashlom bekedei razel latov zel atzmoi. When you're cooking them, it's not open fire, it's cooking, yeah? Afilu betanur koton, upiv soso mutur, afilu lechatchila. I'm reading from the Levush, not from somebody that don't care for halacha. Aval bishapia kedeira is megulim, she'en recha melech chutzal kedeira. By bishul, the recha kedeira doesn't go out. You see some reyach, yeah, you're going to smell, oh, I smell choland, oh, I smell pizza, you... But that's the reach. We're talking about Gemara. We're talking about intense reach smell that comes with a big fire. Stamos a little bit reach. We're not even discussing this. The whole machlokes doesn't apply to here. Vuadin lebosarim cholav nami din hoche. Elash nahagin leachmir lechatchila afilu betanur godol ubedihaved leokil afilu betanur katan. So again, lechatchila, like I said, we're keeping it all separate. We don't do these things lechatchila. We're not so brave, but the evidence has happened. So this thing, again, wrapping the wrapped chicken went inside the toaster oven. Or the tanur, milking a tanur, it's 100% kosher. The chicken, 100%. Anybody says, machmir is mamash, mafsid mamoinam shel Yisrael. And the tanur is 100% kosher. Shkoyach. Yeah. Oh, yeah.